Hey guys, hello and welcome to Zen Innovations. Guys, in this video, I'm going to teach you how to install a stabilizer in DIY manner. Now, these kind of stabilizers are very useful to prevent the voltage fluctuation from reaching to your air conditioner. It could be a washing machine, it could be a fridge, it could be a PC. Practically all home appliances can be safeguarded by the use of a good stabilizer. And yes, do watch this video entirely because I am going to install the stabilizer at a very unique position. Plus, in this video, we are going to talk about a few annoyances that usually come with this kind of stabilizer. Number one being this. Yeah, ugly bare wires. And what my house has is a regular 6 or 16 amp socket. So I'll have to attach a 3-pin plug top on top of this. And this guy over here, oh man, this is even worse. So what this is, that this is there for screwing in this kind of bare wires into these terminals. But the thing is that our home appliances, be it washing machine, be it an expensive fridge, an expensive TV, already comes with a molded plug top. And here generally I see that a lot of people commit this mistake. They simply cut off that plug and put bare wires over here. That kills your warranty of that home appliance. So you need to be very careful for that. But if you watch this guide carefully, we can avoid that. I'm going to teach you how to preserve the warranty of your home appliance. You don't need to cut the plug of your home appliance to install it over here. So all right, what are we waiting for? I'll get all the stuff which is required for making this kind of installation. You guys go down there and hit those nice little like and subscribe buttons for me, and let's begin today's tutorial. Alright guys, so all the stuff that we need for this kind of project is already here. So let's start with this thing. So what I've got here is a 3-pin plug top. And let me tell you guys that please buy good quality material, good branded material, because running heavy duty home appliances like AC or washing machine is not a joke. So what I've brought over here is a 3-pin plug top. This is rated at 6 amp, which is perfect for my application, but if you are planning to run an air conditioner, then you might want to go for a 16 amp 3-pin top. And this 3-pin top will provide the power input to the stabilizer, so we'll connect it over here and then it will deliver power to the stabilizer itself. And coming to the output section, for output, as I've told you, I'm very disappointed with this kind of terminal. So what I'll do is I'll use this kind of surface board. This is a simple board, you can say it is sealed, and in this surface board we are going to install this kind of socket. So this is a 6 by 16 amp socket, which can take both 6 amp and 16 amp plugs, like so. So this is going to provide the output. The socket will be installed over here in this board, and to complete the connection to deliver the power, I also brought a piece of wire over here. Make sure you buy a good pure copper wire. So the thing which I brought is, you can say this thing is rated at 1.5 square meters, which is perfect for fridges or washing machines. And if you are running an air conditioner, make sure to get a 2.5 square mm wire, not any less. But for my application, this is perfect. Okay, so for running AC, you need two modifications. One is a 16 amp plug over here, and the second thing is a thicker wire. Of course, we are going to need a plethora of tools to install all of this. So wire strippers, screwdrivers and all of that. And yes, if you want to buy all of this stuff online, there will be a lot of buying links in the description below. So be it the material for this kind of board, be it the tools, be it the stabilizer itself, please use my affiliate links to support this channel. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to install all of this, and then I'll talk you about the wiring connections and how to go about the wiring color codes. So let's get to it. Guys, I have done with all the wiring and let me show you what I've done. So going by the flow of energy into this machine, the flow of energy will start from here. This is a 3-pin plug. Then it goes to the stabilizer from this thing over here inside. It gets stabilized. You get a good output and the output comes over here and it goes into this board. I've deliberately kept all of this open so that I can explain the wiring to you like that. So let's start with this thing. This is the input side of the stabilizer, and as you can see there are three wires over here, and the easiest wire to understand is this. The green wire is the earth wire. This is the standard which we follow in India. Then we have a red wire which is known as the positive, also known as the phase, and we have a black wire which is known as the negative or the neutral. Actually all of this is marked over here, you can read on the plug. So this is N. I'm not sure how good the camera has been able to focus. This is the live, this is the earth. So this is how a plug, a 3-pin plugs is installed. If you need a dedicated video on this, I already have a video. You can find it here, somewhere here in the I button. So here the energy of flow has started going into the stabilizer. It went in here, and let's talk about the output section. So in the output, we can see that again, we have the very same three wires. Let me focus a little bit. Okay, that's better. So here, as we can see, it's very clearly written. This is the earth. Then we have the neutral, this black thing. And then we have the live, also known as the phase or the positive, which is the red wire. Very simple to understand. Just strip your wires, put them here. Make sure that these screws are nice and tight. Use a good screwdriver, use a good tool so that you can get this thing right. I also did tighten these things. These are the input sides. So the wire which comes from the inside of your stabilizer goes on this section, and I did notice that on my model these were loose, so you might want to check that before you start using the stabilizer. So I did tighten the upper three as well as these things with the wire. And this is a cute little piece of wire actually goes into this cute little board. So the actual config set sits like this. You can see like a father and a child over here. So this is the stabilizer, and I have a small board which is going to just sit here. I wish this was made over here directly. So this is this stupid thing. This is quite useless, but we remedied the situation using this separate board. So this small wire goes into this board. I have a knot over here. This is a very good DIY strain relief kind of thing, so that no one will be able to pull out the wire, say by mistake, if something happens, someone tugs on the cable. So it's not going to come out like that. And here it is connected to this particular socket. So let me explain you that. And it is very clearly written on the socket what is what. So here on the top we have this thing which is the earthing. It is written as E, and it has this wire which is yellow and green in color. Then we have the neutral, which is the black wire, and we have the live, also known as phase, written by the English letter L over here. It's like this actually. It's like this. So this red wire goes into the live part of this socket. And if we see it here from the front, the live or the phase is always towards your right hand side. So this thing, this terminal is going to be the positive. The very same story over here. We can see on the right side, this particular thing, this is the positive. So it goes like this from your home appliance. All right. So what I'll do is I'll close all of this. I deliberately kept it open for you. So I'll close this. I'll close this. There's a plate over here. This thing, it covers this area so that no one can touch this thing. So I'll install all of that. And after that thing, we are going to take a test run of this stabilizer. So let me get through all of this mess. The stabilizer is installed over here. Let me run you through the connections. So first we'll talk about the input. So this is the input which provides the power to the stabilizer. It runs along using a wire like this, and it goes into this box which is the stabilizer itself. And from there the stabilized output comes into this board over here. And in this particular board we can very easily plug in the 3-pin plug top of our home appliances. For example, over here today I have this washing machine which is running very nicely on the stabilizer because it is converting the input voltage to 230-231 volts from a very high 248 volts which is coming from this socket. So 248 volts in from here, which is slightly on the higher side, the stabilizer converts it to 230 or 231, providing a very safe and sound current, or you can say the safe voltage for any kind of your home appliances like this one. So that is how you install a stabilizer and increase the life and safety of your home appliances. Alright guys, so here we are back at our setup, and before I explain the advantages of this kind of setup, let me explain it to you how this kind of stabilizer is actually connected. So as you can see here, this is the stabilizer over here, and the wiring is actually pretty simple. So this is the mains plug. Basically this is the input where the entire system gets its power from the mains, or you can say your electricity board. So this is where the power comes in, and using this kind of thick cable which comes with the stabilizer, the power is actually transferred into the stabilizer over here. And what the stabilizer does is actually it takes this input power, it stabilizes it, it regulates the voltage, and then the power is actually transmitted over here. So these are the output ports. Now this stabilizer actually does not have any kind of you can say the plug socket arrangement, or you can say the kind of 3-pin plug which things have, but it comes with this regular wire kind of setup. So what I had to do is I had to make my own board. So this is how I made it, and this is nothing but a regular switchboard. And the stabilized output from this inverter is actually coming into this little switchboard, and here is what I have plugged in. Now this is nothing but the charging plug of my inverter actually. So this is my inverter over here. As you can see, this is the UTL Gamma Plus. So guys, the flow of power actually is pretty simple. So from mains, the power is flowing through this cable and it comes to this stabilizer first, and from the stabilizer it goes into this board, and from this board, using this mains input cable, it goes inside this inverter. And if you've been paying attention to these figures, actually the advantages of the system are pretty clear. As you can see here that the voltage issue at my place is kind of, you can see the high voltage, and 255 volts can be actually harmful for sensitive electronic devices such as computers. And with the use of this stabilizer, what it actually did is actually it took the 255 volts input, and then it is bringing down that voltage to a much more stable level. So 255 in the input, and in the output it is giving me a very comfortable 219 volts. Now let's check what the inverter is doing over here. And as you can see here, so the inverter is currently running in mains mode. Let's hit the hold button and let me explain it to you. So as you can see here guys, the voltage, the input voltage is 220 volts and over here it shows 219 volts. So basically what we did actually here is that we not only enhanced the safety of this inverter, this machine itself, but this stabilizer is going to enhance the stability of each and every device which is connected to this inverter. Now guys, what we usually do is that our sensitive loads are actually connected to the inverter. So for example, you might have your PCs, your modem, your laptops. So all kind of expensive devices are connected to this inverter. And what we actually successfully did here is that we just purchased one single digital stabilizer, and with this just single stabilizer, we provided safety to all of those gadgets. And plus, as this stabilizer is upstream to this inverter, it is also protecting this inverter in case of any kind of over or under voltage issues. Now this stabilizer is taking in 255 volts and in the output it is making 219 volts. Now 219 volts is being interpreted here as 220 volts. So a 1 volt of difference here and there, you can say, in the margin of error. Alright guys, so this was the method how you can just purchase one digital stabilizer and enhance the safety of variety of devices connected to your inverter. If you would like to buy some kind of stabilizer like this, variety of links will be given in description below. There you can go ahead, buy them, or you can check their prices. And by the way guys, if you like seeing videos like this, make sure to subscribe to this channel and share this video with your friends. Have a nice day guys.